Hi guys, I'm Arundhati. I'm an international badminton player. As we all know that coaches are the unsung heroes of this sport. And in this show, we are going to celebrate these heroes. We'll be knowing their journey, their views, their advices for the upcoming players. It's a little insight in the life of coaches. I'll be asking a few questions to them and I'll be sharing the timestamps with the questions in the description box below. So if you want to skip anything, you can just go and click on the timestamps below. So guys, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Today we have with us Ramesh sir. He's a national level athletic coach. He's a Dronacharya awardee and he's a coach of Duti Chand. And today he'll be sharing his journey, his advices and his knowledge with us. So let's begin.
Hi, sir. Thank you so much for joining us.
Sir, I am a fan of your work and your knowledge because we've been seeing you in our academy since long time. So,
okay.
Sir, please take us through your journey so far.
My journey, because I born in Hanumkonda, very remote area, almost it is like a slum. Then it's Warangal district. So I was just a very ordinary child playing with all my colleagues. It was no big vision or any big targets or any destinations in that age. But I studied in government school. Then I was, when I joined intermediate, so in my street where there was a two senior boy, senior place, they used to go for running. So I just followed them. Then they introduced me to Jawaharlal Nehru Stadium, where it is in Hanumkonda. So there I got R. Pradeep Kumar, who was senior to me. So he has guided me. That's how I came into the sports. Then after that, when I was doing training in degree, I got an ankle fracture.
Okay.
Then I couldn't do any more sport. Then one of my friends said, there is a master of physical education in Karaikudi. Why don't you join? So then I went, I joined Alagappa University. Then I finished 2 years course. Then I came back. Work Kakatiya school. This was a private school. So within 1 year, I could do good results with the boys. Then again, there was a football coach. His name is Premnath. He said, without NIS, you are doing a good coaching. Why don't you go for a diploma course? Then I went and asked the madam. Then she said, okay, you go. I will sponsor. That time, it was a 300 rupees per month. Then I went and joined diploma in NIS. Then I finished off with the toppers. So that was the last batch. They were giving direct jobs without applying. Okay. So that's how I joined Sports Athletics of India.
Okay.
In Chikmagalore. Then up to 2014, I was in the national camps. And yeah. Then I've been dropped from the national camp in athletics. So that time, Gopichand asked me, we want your help for fitness. Then I asked, okay, I'll be there for the time being. Then he wrote letter to DG sir. So that's how the letter has come. Apart from his regular duties, he's been transferred to Gopichand Academy. That's how my journey started with the badminton.
Nice, sir. Nice. You've been coaching since more than 15 years, sir. And So, and you worked with hockey, you're working with athletics, you had a great result, you have a Dronacharya award, sir, and now you're working with badminton also, sir. So, what motivates you?
Yeah, even cricket also, one thing you missed, cricket, tennis.
Cricket also, yes, sorry.
Yeah.
So, what motivates you?
Maybe I realized one thing. I feel very, very happy when national anthem played at international means in other countries. So that will happen when your athlete or any Indian player wins international competition. You know that is a procedure, your national anthem and national flag will go high.
Yeah.
That is the most, it gave me more happiness. That is one thing. And second thing, making the lives. Because in athletics, 99% come from rural and poor background.
Yeah.
Right. So making somebody's life change, it motivates me more. And I enjoy coaching. That may be the reason.
Yes. Sir, now you just said you have been with hockey, cricket, athletics and badminton. Sir, according to you players, what are the differences in regards of training? What are the differences?
Yeah, it's a very good question because many people ask how you do fitness for cricket, then hockey, then track and field.
Yeah.
But early stages, I could find one thing. Because if you want to speak about any religion, you should know Bible, Bhagavad Gita, Quran. If you know, you can speak about all other religions. So that's why the training methods so very, very important. Where I got a good grip over the subject, training methods.
Yeah.
So second thing, I found there is the need of the player and need of the game and the position what he plays. If you narrow the gap, that will be the best fitness. The fair point is that individual requirement and his game requirement and what position he plays. So narrow the gap, that is the best fitness.
Sir, any specific instances how you improve the fitness of hockey team, senior players, hockey team members when you were working with them?
Yeah, because before Sydney Olympics, I sat with a physiologist to know the energy systems, what are the energy system work for the hockey. Then with biomechanics, that what are the major muscles and all. Then training methods experts so that what is the periodization, maybe single or double or multi periodations. And before that, I have a track and field experience also. So I could found in the hockey that in the initial stages, they were not able to bend back because there were a lot of senior players played for the 10 years. So I found the back stretching and all, it was a little difficult. Then I found, okay, they've been playing for many years.
Yeah.
So that is the reason the muscles. Oh, but reverse muscles not work very much. Then in the initial stages, 3 weeks, I did just reverse exercise what in hockey they use. Then after 3 weeks, then Dhanraj Pillai and all Delhi, sir, we are feeling that our body's lock is being opened. So that's how the free body movements end up happening. And the biggest thing in the hockey is a peaking. So it is Mukesh Kumar, who is a triple Olympian and Padma Shri.
Yeah.
Arjun Award. He said me, in the games, you just bring 98% of peak. The 2% of peak will take care in the matches because there is a rest and match.
Mm.
So that is the reason I got a good compliment when Federation Secretary asked one of the players, what is the difference you found in Ramesh and before trainers? Then he said, before trainers, first two matches we used to play good. Then our performance used to deteriorate. Mm. But when Ramesh has come in, match to match, we are becoming more fitter towards finals.
Okay.
So this is one thing. Then second thing, I mix up. Coaching is not only a science, but to a great extent, it is an art. So I take trainings from the science base, then I'll make it very artistic way. So once the Mukesh in the one of the papers, he said, newspapers, when Ramesh sir is making us do training, after going to room only will come to know how hard training we have done.
Okay.
So that is the way I did it, and there was a lot of senior players, because at that time I was too young. Dhanraj Pille and all, I used to see them in the TVs, newspapers and all.
Yeah.
But I gelled up with them very well, and one of the fittest team, they say, in the Sydney.
Wow.
By seeing that only, BVS Lakshman came to me.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow, sir. But yeah, I mean, sir, I'll go a little personal.
Yes.
Sir, how you felt when you left the athletics national camp and you came to Hyderabad?
Yeah, because I really felt bad, because I worked so hard, because in athletics the camp start from January and it ends December. You believe me or not, once in, I think, 2011 or 2012, 1.5 year, in 1.5 year, once 4 days, once 6 days, I came home, being in Patiala. So, and the Asian Games, 2014 Asian Games, the team has got a gold medal, for and even Asian Games record, even Puamma got a bronze medal.
Yeah.
Then I've been dropped. But I always believed in destiny, because in my total career, how Indian hockey team has come, because I was working in the sports school hockey, Hakimpet. There was a little misunderstanding between sports school director as well as Sai.
Okay.
So because of their misunderstanding, I've been surrendered to Bangalore. So there I got a hockey opportunity.
Okay.
So again here, so when they dropped, then I came here immediately, Gopichand offer came.
Yeah.
So now after dropping from there, I got a Gopichand, Dutichand, Dronacharya. So I always believe in a destination. If you do, you are doing good work. So just whatever happens, it is good for you. So that's what it had. Because my real-time experience taught me, it's not like a book. Because everybody say, they take everything happen for good. But it happened with me. So that's why I take it. I look back. Whenever such type of things happen, I look back whether I did any mistake. If I did do mistake, then definitely I'll feel God wants me to the bigger. Because if I might have been surrendered to Bangalore, my life might have ended with Hakimpet Sports School from Alwal, Secunderabad. So from there, I realized, oh, it's a destiny. So just keep moving.
So that's your mantra.
Yeah.
Yeah, sir. Nice. Sir, let's go ahead. I want to ask you, you have trained the athletes from rural background and urban background, both. So, aapko isme kya difference lagta hai? What is the difference between them mentally, physically?
Yeah. So, ispe game ke upar bhi depend karta hai. Kyunki na, thode game rehte hain, abhi athletics hai. 99% rural or poor backgrounds aate hain. Jaisa tennis hai, badminton hai, to cricket bhi hai. To above middle class and rich class se aate hain. So, that also makes a difference. And some of the games you required, it's a sheer genetical talent. For example, 100 meters.
Yeah.
If you don't have a speed and all, you can't withstand. And some of the games are badminton. Medium talent hai, but you have a hard-working nature and very good habits. And if you're getting a good coach, you can survive. So that is what one thing I found, and game to game, as I said, athletics and all, once they have faith, there will be faith. Okay, forever they will be. And some of the rich games, you cannot expect, because as long as you are useful to them, okay, then after that, it may not be. But in athletics, such type of games and rurals, from especially rural background, they will be forever. It's not means it's all different, because what is your family background sound? That's a very important. How you brought up? It's not rural and city, but definitely from the rural areas, they will be very strong, because since childhood they are exposed to the hard work.
Yeah.
Right. That way they will be physically strong compared to urban, and rest of the things is maybe the genetics and the atmosphere you have brought up, that makes a lot of difference.
So what difference did you feel mentally between rural and the urban players?
Yeah, I said no. Rural and urban, I found is a physically little differences.
Yeah.
But mentally very less, because rural people are not being exposed much.
Okay.
And the city children, they will be little faster because they're exposed to so many things. But at the end, I want to say, is, as you said, the mentality and behaviors and all, first thing is the family background and then which atmosphere they have been brought up. And the game, right? So this makes a difference, not so much rural to only the physical abilities.
Sir, as you said that you have come from the village background and from village, and where there is very less literacy about sports and coaching. Sir, how did you manage to come up till here, won the Dronacharya Award, and what were the challenges you faced during that time?
Yeah, to be frank, I want to say that my father's name is Mallaya and mother's name Palama. My father was a attender in electricity board, and my mother used to work for the homes. So it was a tough, but I could learn hard working from my mother, and helping nature is my from my father, because that's the way I'm telling how you are, whether rich or poor or you are rural or urban background, but from the home atmosphere you learn. So really, it was a challenge, because I have to work, then I have to study, I have to train, and that time I realized sometimes my coach used to say evening I was not able to run properly because I have to work, labor work more. So here training, diet is not much.
Yeah.
Then you are tired with the physical work. Again you are coming and running. So that used to pain me more. Then afterwards only I realized that was the reason. Then second thing, challenges, I can say, challenge means everything is challenge, but how you take is important, because I always say, whenever it comes, you take up and go over, then you can reach your destiny. So the challenges is that, because in intermediate I got I failure, then that time it was a very tough time, then I got a fracture.
Yeah.
So that was a little problem. Then suddenly they transferred me to from Hyderabad to Bangalore. That was a little tough. Then when they drop. And sometimes we used to work Indian team for the Olympic and all. Sometimes they used to drop. They used to send somebody else with the team. So, but at the end, it's all in the life. How you take them is important. Whether it's you take it as a challenge. I always say there is no hardships. Either it is a, some people say that bad time, and I ask it, there is a good times or challenging times. There is no bad times in life. So that's what
very positive.
Yeah,
very positive. So it was really, really inspiring. Like you came from the village, and then you topped your course. And then you, after you, I mean, I think your journey is like step by step, one step at a time, one step at a time, one step at a time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, because I always, one more thing I want to say here, in one of the movies, Amitabh Bachchan acted in that. He says, the man is not great, situation makes man great.
Yes.
To become a topper in diploma in NS, actually I joined in diploma Bangalore center. So there was army guys, 10-11 guys were there in our class. So for any doubt clearance, they used to come to me. So I used to clear the doubts. So there was a class test. So in the class test, this army people got a more mark than me. So they were making fun of me after having that drink. उसने उसको ही कुछ नहीं आता, हमको पढ़ाया उससे ज्यादा मार्क्स हम लिया. सो जस्ट आई वॉन्टेड टू गेट अ लिटिल मोर मार्क्स देन देम द फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर आफ्टर 3 months एवरी सेमेस्टर. सो आई वर्क लिटिल हार्ड. So that made me not only get a more marks than them, I stood topper in the class.
But top,
so yeah. You have to maintain that top. So that's how I continue. So that is a situation. Sometimes I see the situation makes man great. It's not.
But you made that situation as a motivation, right, sir?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. So
that was the thing.
Yeah, sir. Sir, as you're working with physical literacy now. So tell us something about physical literacy and your approach towards coaching. Has it changed over time?
Yeah, it's not only changed my coaching, even my life, but now my way of thinking. But because especially in physical literacy, two, three things attracted me very well. Because once I was in the 2016, I was in Trivandrum. So Gopichand called me. Now there is age wise there is a windows to develop, and we are missing it. And a lot of training. We are thinking. We are not thinking multilateral development and all round development of children. Then I said. This article I studied long back when I was in the NAS in 1992, because there was a windows, because that really I got a Xerox, but that time also I heard, oh, these are the each age, what are the things develops. So I said, okay, this real, I said, it really clicks. Then Gopichand team, really they worked, they formulated values and active start and in a systematic way. So really, I liked in that values, because one example I want to tell you, in that they say that trust, in the trust in PL, they say that intention and competency. So sometimes your intention will be good, but competency may not be there. For example, how it happened when I realized, when I went back, I was working in the Chikmagalur. Yeah. So one girl athlete was there. So I asked her to run 1 kilometer repetitions 3 times. So what targets I have given, she was not able to do. So I was scolding her. So then after a few minutes, another girl came to me and she told me, sir, yesterday night, her father drank and came and bit her. She could not take dinner and she slept. So that's the reason she is not able to do the target. She's struggling to run. Then I realized, see this here, trust, intention. My intention is she should do good targets. And her intention also to do a good target. Otherwise, she might have come to the ground.
Yeah.
But she is not having competency. This she's not able to do because her father bet her and she did not have. So then I realized, oh. So from there onwards, if anybody comes to ground late, first of all, I ask, okay, did you sleep yesterday night? Mm-hmm. The water was running in the bathroom or not? Mm-hmm. So that is the way it changes. First, you listen to the child. So which is them. So suddenly, then I started. His intention is there, but competence is not able to do there. So that's how many, and gratitude and so many other things. Then one more thing from the PL I like is teaching styles. Because there is unstructured play, means just leaving the players, okay, today you do. Semi-structured, you are telling this is the work you have to do, but rest of you have to plan. Then third is a structured training, only completely you make it. So that makes me a full coaching, because I was reading that if you are like everything, you start taking care of the athlete, then the merit is they will feel more confident. But demerit is they feel dependent.
Okay.
So if some people will be there completely free, so they feel insecure but independent. So another theory, like like a semi-structured. Means when easy trainings are there, you are telling, okay, go and do yourself. Very important training session is there, you are going. So that in that case, the player will feel secure as well as independent. So those two things that has come from the PL. Then third thing, the child expresses in a different way. Some child want always show his potentiality. Best mai kya kar sakta hu. One child is cooperating. He always want to be with all in group and all. Some child want adventure. Will jump from there. Will do from there. And some people aesthetic sense means they will whatever they do very beautifully they will be doing. So you have so many qualities in the child. So one is a child can express himself in a different ways. Adventure, competitive, and in a team and aesthetic way. So that when child comes to you, so that you prepare a training, give an opportunity for them to express themselves in a different angles and exploit their qualities also. Because one example I learned here, adventure means Duti Chand. Once Duti Chand told me, I asked Duti Chand, whenever she goes international competition, she is never afraid. Because I seen many athletes in the national level and international level. National level they do okay. International level they go, they have a little fear. Yeah. So when but Duti is not like that. She always love to compete rather than train. And she love to compete. So I asked, आपको डर नहीं लगता क्या? So she told me when I was 10 years old, भुवनेश्वर में मेरा दीदी बोला है, पैसा देके तुम जाके जगन्नाथ टेम्पल का दर्शन करके आओ. So Duti climbed up in the bus and she was sitting. So conductor को doubt आएगा, यार ये छोटा लड़की है, ऐसे ही miss she ऐसे ही छूट के आ गया. तो शी वो डाउट नहीं आने के लिए क्या किया, वो एक फैमिली के साथ बैठा हुआ. सो दैट व्हेन शी सिट विद द फैमिली कंडक्टर वोंट गेट अ डाउट दैट दिस गर्ल. तो लाइक दैट शी ट्रैवल्ड टू जगन्नाथ टेंपल एंड शी डिड अ दर्शन एंड शी केम बैक. सो एट द एज ऑफ 10 इयर्स एंड शी इज बीन एक्सपोज्ड सच अ थिंग शी बिकेम अ फियरलेस. तो व्हेन वी वर चाइल्ड वो मत करना, वो करने से ये होता है, ये कूदने से गिर जाता. मीन्स विदाउट अवर नॉलेज वी स्टार्टेड गेटिंग फियर्स इन अवर ब्रेन. सो मोस्ट ऑफ दैट दे विल कंटिन्यू. सो अगर जब भी बोलता है कुछ नहीं होता, अच्छा करो, देख के जंप करो, कुछ नहीं होता. सो बिकॉज ऑफ फियर आई कुड कलेक्ट ऑल दोस थिंग्स एंड आई एम इम्प्लीमेंटिंग दैट ट्रेनिंग. देन बिफोर वी यूज्ड टू थिंक नो सपोज इफ यू आर लूजिंग क्या कैरियर है, क्या स्पोर्ट्स करके क्या करेगा, ऐसा नहीं. बिकॉज स्पोर्ट फॉर लाइफ. स्पोर्ट इज ए ब्यूटिफुल फीलिंग, राइट? यू सो दैट्स व्हाट वी लर्न फ्रॉम द पीएल. इट्स नॉट स्पोर्ट ओनली, द विनिंग इज अ बोनस. एंड दिस द सेम थिंग इवन कश्यप सेज. समटाइम्स ही सेज, सर व्हाट एवर आई एम गेटिंग इज बोनस सर, अस्थमा ये राइट के कौन सर. सो दिस ऑल बोनस. आई एम ग्रेटफुल टू गॉड. God is allowing me to play. I'm very happy that I allowed to play. So the beautiful concept that should be the winning is a bonus. So that concept I got from the PL and I'm implementing and I'm more enjoying the coaching. Because end of the day, for me, PL is a physical activity for a human and be best in your life. That's what I learned from the PL.
Nice, sir. Great. I mean, really great insights, sir, in the physical literacy topic and how you changed your approach towards coaching.
Yeah.
Timely. So,
in PL, one more thing I want to say. They teach us a gratitude. So, many times as a player, if you win or a coach, somebody wins, I made. By seeing that gratitude means it's not your own, you're not your alone efforts to make a champion. So there are so many people's help and involvement there. For example, now on Sports Authority of India, if anybody wins, I say show your medal to gatekeeper and cook in the mess. And who cleans the bathrooms then, right? So who cleans the ground? Because if they don't clean, if he doesn't cook, you cannot become a champion. So that is where, and as a coach is also, I don't want to claim that because of me. Because if he's not having a talent, or his mother, father not allowed, our system is not allowed, I can't make a champion. That is the reason in Bhupichand case, from Japan, one man came to make a documentary on Japan. Bhupichand from the Japan. Oh. He asked end of the shoot, he asked me, Ramesh, when everybody left her, what made you to support her? Then I told him, everybody says it, but really I'm grateful and thankful to God. He has given me an opportunity to play a role of coach to Bhupichand. It is her destiny. So that then, that's what I learned from the PL, how you have to be. You have to be. Even Bhupichand always says, for work, you be one step ahead. For credit, take one step back. So this is a beautiful say from Bhupichand.
So as you said, the topic, as you took out the topic of gratitude, I have asked many badminton coaches, ki, according to the coaches, does player recognize the effort put by the coaches or not?
Oh, it's all, that's what I'm telling you. It's all on us. Because if I think I did everything, if it's not taking the name, then you feel bad. So you, that's what I said, you thankful to God, he has given me the opportunity to play the role, means you never going to hide, right? If you are just, your returns, you are expecting, means you will get hard, right? Yeah. If you know, all is just giving, you are thankful to God, the opportunity you got, you are playing the role. If he gives credit to you, it is a bonus. Doesn't, okay, so fine. That's what the legend coaches and great coaches, that is the difference. Because that's why I too heard many times in the thankless job and all. But it's all how you take your shaping. Look, it doesn't matter. See, somebody prepares, makes your shoe. Do you know the name of that who made a shoe? No. Never know. But you are wearing beautiful shoe. Somewhere else that name is doing. So it's all philosophies, how you take.
Okay, sir. Great. Sir, as you said, the Dyuti Chand, as you supported Dyuti Chand during her tough phase. So my next question is on that. How did you manage to motivate Dyuti Chand during her tough phase? And because in 2014, the controversy started, and in 2016, she was the third Indian woman to participate in 100-meter race in Olympics. So during that time, 2 years of time, how did you manage to motivate her, and how did you manage to motivate yourself during that time, sir?
Yeah, really, again, that's true. Here again, I can say one day she called me from the from her village. Actually, when I was in Glasgow, she called me, sir, abhi kya hoga mera? So, sir, these are the things happened. She was literally crying. Yeah. Then I said, okay, I am coming back. And I said, dekho, share, 4 din jeeta hai, lekin apne shaan se jeeta hai. So, hamesha rone ka zarurat nahi hai humko. For everything, there is a solution. Main aapko ek baat ka guarantee deta hoon, kyunki it's me I have brought from her village to Patiala for the camp. So I felt little guilty if I might it have brought from her village to Patiala and made this much performance, then she might have been happy at her village. So I somewhere else felt I am responsible for all these things. Since I felt, then I said, Dhuti, ek baat aapko deta hun. As long as I'm alive, 3 times food I can give. So that's take it guarantee from me. Then when I came to Hyderabad, this one day she called me. And again, I'm telling you the destiny. You see, I've been dropped from the national camp. Yeah. And again, Gopichand asked me to come and help badminton play. So that I came to the academy. And same time, Dhuti called me. Sir, abhi mere ko koi bhi idhar nahi hai, koi bhi dekhta nahi. Then immediately I put a one word to Gopichand. This is what. He didn't know that about who is Dhuti Chand, what is level of Dhuti Chand. Immediately said, na, just one girl, no problem, let her come. So immediately I told the Dhuti. Then within 24 hours, she landed in Gopi Chand Academy at free food, free stay, and rest is the history. And even in Operation Games, she said, when I came to Gopi Chand Academy, I was having 500 rupees. Now she has got a BMW car and 3 crores Asian Games cash prize. Yeah. And as you said, it was very tough time for me because I used to stay in Alwar.
Yeah.
I was having a scooter. 35 kilometers, I have to get up at 4:30, prepare training, and I start 1 hour before I come here. So she used to sit at Gopi Chand Academy, the front, that footpath is there. She used to sit, then I have to pick up her and to go to the Chiboli ground and train again. I have to drop her back, then I have to work for academy 10 to 11:30 and sleep. Again, 3:30 pick up and go there and train again, drop her, and I have to rush to Alwal because it used to take 1 hour. Then again, next to her. It was, sometimes it was body used to ache me like anything. Oh, because week long, morning, evening, travel and training. Sometimes she used to feel very low, sir. Raat ko mujhe neend nahi aaya. What will be my career? I said, Dhuti, हमारे हाथ में क्या है वो करना है, जो हमारे हाथ में नहीं है ये नॉट बॉदर, हमारे हाथ में सिर्फ ट्रेनिंग है, ट्रेनिंग करें, राइट, वी आर नॉट हार्म एनीबॉडी और वी आर नॉट चीटेड एनीबॉडी, लेट अस सी. सो दैट्स व्हाट आई यूज्ड टू मोटिवेट हर, एंड गॉड्स ग्रेस शी यूज्ड टू बी वेरी कंफर्टेबल एंड रियली बैडमिंटन एटमॉस्फेयर बिकॉज यू कैन सी 4:30 से राइट रात तक खेलते रहते हैं सभी.
yeah.
और बड़ा बड़ा प्लेयर है, कश्यप है उधर, सिंधु, ऑल बिग बिग प्लेयर. सो दैट आल्सो इनडायरेक्टली मोटिवेटेड हर. एंड फॉर मी देयर वाज नो टाइम फॉर मी टू थिंक बिकॉज मॉर्निंग इवनिंग वॉकिंग एंड स्लीपिंग रीडिंग डूइंग. आई होप दैट मेड अस टू कीप केप्ट गोइंग.
Yeah, sir. I mean, actually, after that, Dhuti, I mean, rose like a phoenix, sir. Like from ashes, she just rose like phoenix. I mean, I was there during that time in academy, and I was able to see her hard work, and your hard work. I mean, it was great, sir, and it was very inspiring seeing her work so hard, and she got all the fruits which she has been working for. And you also, sir, I mean, really, I was really grateful to experience a little of your hard work, sir. And
good thing, because some of the things I want to do, Dhuti has got a specialty that she helps everybody. I want to tell one example of her. When we were in the national camp, she won individual gold medal. She has been given a good cycle. So in the national camp, I was in the gym. I was just coming out from the gym. So one senior athlete, 400 meters, she was taking her cycle. Then Dhuti was fighting with her. No, it's my cycle. Then after that senior girl left, I called Dhuti. That time she was only 16 years class. Right? I told Dhuti, hum kisi ko dene se Bhagwan hamein और देता है. दिस इज व्हाट आई सेड एंड लेफ्ट. विदिन हाफ एन आवर शी कॉल्ड मी, सर मैं वो साइकिल का लॉक तोड़ दिया, हॉस्टल में बोल दिया ये साइकिल सभी यूज करो. सो प्रोबेबली व्हाटएवर हार्डशिप्स हैज कम देयर इज आई ऑलवेज सी बिकॉज व्हाट इज हु कम्स एंड हेल्प हर. आई होप इन अ बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम शी हैज कम्स आउट लाइक एनीथिंग.
Yeah.
So probably this is the quality she has. Recently, I heard in the New Year Day, she has arranged 2 buses for her village older people on her own money to go to Jagannath temple, have a free prayer and prasad and come back. So she does such type of things.
Wow.
So probably that is a very good strength in her. And when I asked her what made you to do that, the old people to go, so she asked me, sir aap log bhi aisa hi help karte hain na, udhar dekha hai academy mein dusron ko aisa hi. So this part, because many they learn by seeing you rather than listening to you.
Thank you, such an inspiring.
So my coaching philosophy, yeah, abhi abhi bahut log aake poochte rehte hain, सर हमारा बच्चे को चैंपियन बनाने के लिए क्या करने हैं, क्या केयर देने हैं। मैं बोलता हूँ पहले यू मेक हिम ए गुड ह्यूमन बीइंग, ही विल बिकम अ ग्रेट चैंपियन।
राइट सर, करेक्ट, ग्रेट सर, ग्रेट एडवाइस सर। सर लेट्स गो टू मोर कोचिंग, योर कोचिंग फिलोसॉफीज सर। हाउ डू यू आइडेंटिफाई टैलेंट इन अ प्लेयर एंड what do you value the most in a player, like his or her talent or his or her skills?
Yeah, here it's again I'm telling it's a requirement of a game. See, I always believe that the making a champion is a relation, or it is a relation between a good culture and a good stone. Suppose if the stone is not good, if you are a great sculptor, if to go to finer nose, eyes, lips, it will break down. If the stone is very, very good, but you are not a sculptor, good sculptor, you cannot make a good statue. So it is a combination of a good coach and talented athlete. And here again, I said game to game. For example, where there is a skill dominant game is there. For example, cricket or badminton, their mediocre talent and very hard working and never give up attitude can survive. But some of the games like 100 meters, you never give up attitude, is there hard work. If you don't have a basic speed, you may not do anything there. So it is a talent versus nurturing. Alone, suppose I'm having extraordinary talent, but I don't do training and I don't have a good coach, I can't realize my potentiality. So it is a combination between, that's why they say the champions are born and made. So champions are not only born, champions are not only made, champions are born and made. So this is the combination. So I look for talent, but I always hear one more thing I want to say that here, for the coaches or anybody, some may born rich, some may born poor. But no child comes into this world without talent. It's our duty to find out what talent he has got. So that is what in, again, PL, it comes as guidance. Yeah. So he can guide them properly, right? Because nobody will come to this talent without talent. Without talent, because God never sends. So hum log hamesha bolte rehte, tu waste hai, tu kaam nahi aata. Bhai, yahan kaam nahi aata, dusre jagah kaam aayega na.
Right, sir.
Jahan kaam aata hai, udhar bhejo usko. So this is what about the talent, because in track and field we have an opportunity to shift the events. Abhi isko speed nahi hai, endurance mein hai. Agar fighting nature achcha hai, patience hai, usko walking mein dal sakte hai. Aisa. So that is what I always, when it talent is comes, so talent, what suits for that particular individual is making, guiding them is a right thing. Otherwise, if I am good at singles, I am good at sprints, I am making everybody to sprint. No, that doesn't work.
So it's a combination, sir. Talent and
skill. Yeah, it's a combination. And the requirement of your field. I told you, some of the way the skill and strategy, mediocre talent and hardworking nature will make you. But where sure talent is required, I don't think there your interest or hard work rather than talent.
Got it, sir. Sir, as you worked with, you're working on a physical literacy, LTAD, long-term athlete development program. Sir, according to you, do you think the younger generation is self-motivated these days?
Yeah, again, I told you just now, nobody born bad. So it's what type of atmosphere we create for the younger generation, that counts, right? I feel that only, because it's atmosphere what you are going to create, because younger generation has got a more exposure.
Yeah.
Right? Because when you are small, because we never have a smartphone.
Yeah.
इसलिए अभी भी जोक बोलते हैं ना, जब हम लोग बचपन में थे, घर कब आता पूछते थे, अभी लोग बोल रहे हैं घर से बाहर कब जाएंगे. So, खेलने के लिए तो ये ट्रेंड है. And one is another one, PL का बहुत important aspect इसलिए है. देखो मैं PL की इसलिए और एक why I want to value. See, your study. You may be drop out at 6th class or 7th or 8th or 10th. You may not continue for studies. But the age of 30 years, if you want to study newspaper or any book, you don't need to go for any more classes or any more teaching. But a child is not exposed to the physical activities at the early stages. At the age of 30 years, if you wanted to do some fitness or anything, he's becoming illiterate. So he can't go to the trainer or anything. So that is what literacy. There you are not studied, but at least you can read the newspaper. So that is the reason at early stages, every child is being exposed to the physical activities. It's a lifelong help for him.
Yeah.
Younger generation, we should give a lot of opportunities to play. Look, somebody is good. He likes dancing. Let him dance. If somebody wants to play a local game, let him play a local game.
Yeah.
So such type of activities should be given. And I always say, because like a child at early stages, I heard in USA, a small kid draw a single just line on the newspaper, white paper. They appreciate, oh, beautiful line you have drawn. So that is the appreciation we have to find in the child. When they are young, their brain, mind is like a white paper. So draw a beautiful drawing rather than making all lines where they don't have a clarity about the future. So that is the way if you guide the younger generation and with the proper way and making a good atmosphere, I don't think there is any change in it, because definitely there will be change according to the exposure, but we too have to change.
Got it, sir. So, but Abhi, a few days back, the news came that the sports minister of India has actually going to put physical literacy in a curriculum school also. So it will be a subject. I mean, that's what I saw the news about
it. Yeah, it's a good, it's a good attempt, because it's a physical literacy in the school, not only schools, even in the communities. So our dream is that from child to end, everybody should involve in physical activity, because whether children are the elderly people, so they should enjoy that physical activity. So then you can find out the healthy nation and happy nation. And you know, physical activity is one of the ingredients for the happiness. So many things are dependent even for the career also, because you know, Sundar Pichai, he says that I was a captain for cricket in Usmania University, that's why I could lead. So he's able to lead one of the biggest companies. So he got that leadership quality from the sport. So that's where the physical literacy is very, very important for even to life. So not only becoming a champion in the sport, but you can champion in your life. To become a champion in the life, physical literacy is very, very important. Early stages or mid or later stages. In every stage of your life. Because of physical literacy, physical activity, so sharir ko involve karna hai. So when you ask somebody, who is your real-time life partner? Koi bolta hai, mera wife. Koi husband bolta hai. Koi mother, father. Koi daughter, son. Koi bolta hai, friend. But real mein ye koi aapka real-time partner नहीं है, life partner नहीं है, आपका real-time life partner है आपका body. अगर body respond करना बंद हो गया कोई, so that is the importance of physical literacy, because physical literacy is your permanent address and taking care of your body. It is only your responsibility. Nobody can come and take care.
Very true, sir. Very true. Very true. Now, sir, how can a coach influence a player's life for good?
There was a small kid in Chennai. So, jab ground mein aata hai, to coach bolta hai, nothing is impossible for sportsmen. Hum ye kar sakte hai. When he went to school, nobody can swim across. So, chota sa ladka utke bolta hai, sir, is it difficult for my coach also? So that is the mindset the player will have. अभी भी देखो ना, कोई भी कहीं भी प्रॉब्लम होता है ऐसे कोच को बोलते हैं. अभी अभी हमारे अगर फेडरेशन में या कहीं भी कुछ प्रॉब्लम होता है तो कोच को बोलते हैं यार तेरा स्टूडेंट पकड़ो बोल. सो कोच हैज गॉट अ लॉट ऑफ इन्फ्लुएंस ऑन द प्लेयर वेदर इट इज अ गुड और बैड. सो वी हैव टू बी वेरी वेरी आई कैन से दैट स्टूडेंट इज अ कॉन्फिडेंशियल रिपोर्ट ऑफ कोच. सो यू हैव टू बी वेरी वेरी केयरफुल व्हेन हैंडलिंग द चाइल्ड एंड what are the values you are teaching, because we should make a good citizen of good citizen rather than a champion. So definitely there will be a lot of influence on the player. Hum log national camp mein rehte to Virender Punia the, wo Krishna Punia ke husband. So he used to tell bhai Ramesh ke student se seekho agar discipline seekhna hai, that's how you deal your students. So it definitely has a lot of influence.
Sir, the first point I understood is to make a player a good human being, and the champion will come later.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sir, how to become that coach? The athlete wants to play for, athlete wants to work for, and athlete wants to win for, according to you.
Yeah, because that's why we have to find out the attitude of the player also, right? As long as he has got a to become a champion, you just make him keep on winning, right? So the stage has come where he can enjoy the sport. Let him enjoy. Let be him a role model for the rest of the players, because still push. Because that day, other day, Gopichand father was telling me he had a very personal bitter experiences, because when Gopichand was suffering knee surgeries, some of the coaches said bhai iska kaam ho gaya. So father felt very very bad, because that was a time where they can't afford big operations and all, so it hurt him very much. So that is the reason till now Gopi's father says, a player, as long as he wants to play, please allow him. We don't know when he comes back. So beautiful theory I learned from him. Then definitely, see, athletics ka example bolta hu. Abhi koi ladka shot put phek raha hai 20 meter. Abhi usko Asian Games, wahan agar medal ka chances nahi hai. But you don't make them retire. Kyunki jo इंडिया में फर्स्ट आना है तो उसको बीट करने के लिए 20 मीटर फेंकना पड़ेगा. सो दैट्स हाउ यू कैन मेंटेन हियर आल्सो इन आवर बैडमिंटन आल्सो. टू सपोज फॉर एग्जांपल नाउ सीनियर प्लेयर्स आर देयर, समटाइम्स दे मे नॉट परफॉर्म एट इंटरनेशनल लेवल, बट दे विल बी डेफिनेटली अ बेंचमार्क फॉर द अपकमिंग प्लेयर्स.
यस,
सो दैट्स व्हाट यू कैन मेक देम विन. You make them enjoy playing, and you can make them good giving back to the sport. And overall, they should be the happiest man in the life. Because what you like more, if you do, that positive energy will transfer into your professional life and family life also. So same thing happened. Other way around, I will tell. One software engineer came to me. सर मुझे आई वॉन्ट टू गो टू ओलंपिक्स. उसका एज था 30 ईयर्स. तो मैं समझ गया इसका प्रॉब्लम क्या है. ओके यू कम. फिर थोड़े दिन के बाद में पूछा क्या प्रॉब्लम तुमको अर्ली स्टेजेस में. नहीं सर मेरे पापा मम्मी मेरे को बिल्कुल ग्राउंड नहीं जाने देते थे, पढ़ना पढ़ना पढ़ना. तो सो उसने बहुत मैंने बोला ठीक है आप आ जाओ. फिर थोड़े दिन के बाद में स्लोली ये अंडरस्टूड सर अभी मैं ये उम्र में तो ओलंपिक्स नहीं जा सकता. मैं बोला आप ओलंपिक्स नहीं जा सकते, लेकिन आप जो चाहते हैं वो तो कर रहे हैं, या उनके साथ ट्रेनिंग करो और किसी को मदद चाहिए तो मदद करो ऐसा. देन आफ्टर सम टाइम 4-5 months ही केम एंड टोल्ड सर आई एम वेरी हैप्पी. प्रीवियसली इन माय ऑफिस दे यूज्ड टू से दैट आई यूज्ड टू इरिटेट एंड दे यूज्ड टू फाइट विद अस एंड आई यूज्ड टू टॉक अबाउट रूल्स. नाउ आफ्टर कमिंग हियर आई एम कॉर्डियल विद एवरीबॉडी. आई एम एबल टू वर्क एक्सट्रीम.
Sir, and what are the qualities you would like to see in the upcoming coaches?
Yeah, because I always believe each profession needs different qualities, especially in the society. A doctor, teacher, coach. You need qualities, right? You have to come to this job to give the coaching. Don't come to this job for coaching for the sake of job. I hope you understood.
Yeah, right. I understood. Yeah.
Right? Okay. Don't come to this profession for the sake of job.
Yeah.
Right? You, for the sake of coaching, you take this job. See, two different small line is there.
Yeah, there's a small line between. Yes, I got it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm only for my employment sake, I'm coming to this profession, then I will do 10 to 5.
Yeah.
Especially doctor also, right? Teacher also, because these are some of the professions you need as different qualities. That's the reason, you see. Very few coaches get success. Others also, they work hard, the hours made, and so many athletes also, so many players. Some get, because these qualities, they may be missing. So I feel, as a coach, I think these are the core, because you should come to this profession for the sake of coaching, not for
sake of a job.
Somewhere I read that coaching is such a profession. You have to be happy by seeing somebody's achievement.
Yeah.
So you're training somebody and he will achieve, but he may not be there or not, but you're still happy. It's not your own. So that is the beauty of this profession. You have to be happy by somebody's achievement.
Yeah.
So that is another angle of coaching.
Sir, and according to you, what should be the general coaching system of India?
First of all, I want to say that we must make a sport for all. Means we should see that every child should be given a chance or allowed to play. And the freedom of coaching. Because see, I myself face a lot of problems. Because I used to go for one ground for giving a training. There, that ground will just say that you don't have a permission. Right? Way to go. So I want is that if whoever wants to play, he should be have a ground to play.
Yeah.
He should have a chance to train under somebody. And who wants to train, giving coaching, he should have a place to give coaching and free to give coaching. I hope this is what I feel. There should not be any restriction for the play and coaching.
Okay. Got it, sir. Sir, and I want to ask you, how is the support for you from the association, from Sai and Mitra Foundation these days?
Yeah, because Sai Gopichand Mitra Foundation, when 3 years back we started, we never thought that this will give us so much of impact, because it was Gopichand's brainchild, that it was never before in the system, supplement and complement to the Sai. So what are the shortcomings in the Sai? So they were filling that gaps. So whether you may say physios, or you may ground assistant or assistant coaches. Because Gopichand said, Rameshana's brain should be used for only coaching, not for writing, not for arranging all those things. That's how the support helped me.
Yeah.
You know the impact, because we later only we came to know it's not only made the lives to change so many kids. And the greatest thing one happened is, normally parents make the career of children. But in our project, children are making the career of parents. Means how means? One of the girl won the national, she broke the national record. Our Sai Gopichand Mitra project has given some cash incentive.
Yeah.
Some government, local MLA has given some money. So her parents, they used to work daily wages. So she got 1 lakh or 1.5 lakh rupees. So she has given 30,000-40,000 to her parents. They bought a goats. So 6, 7, 8 goats. Now they stopped going to daily wage work. Then they stood on their own feet. They are doing that work. And one of the girl, Deepthi's mother. Deepthi's mother also used to go for a daily wage work. So she got a Youth Asia medal and all. She got 1-1.5 lakh rupees. So she has given a money to her mother, some money. So she buy cow, and now she's selling the milk. She's no more going to a daily wage work. So here is Ulta. So children are making the career for the parents. That's what the great impact happened. We never knew that this will happen.
Great, sir. Great, sir. This was really great. And I did see some of the Mitra Foundation girls training in the Gachibowli Stadium a few days back before the lockdown. Yeah. I mean, really inspiring and motivating to see all these girls and kids training together and doing their training. I mean, it was really good, sir. Really nice. Sir, as our conversation been so far, I wanted to ask, and with your experience of more than 15 years in this coaching field, I wanted to ask, according to you, what is the difference between winning and succeeding?
Yeah, because winning, I mean, a beautiful question you asked me. Yesterday I was seeing that Mahabharata.
Yeah.
Karna comes to Bhishma and says, after my death also, Bhishma says, I can't give Ashirvad to become a winner. So then Karna bolta hai ke bhai mereko sanman mile aisa Ashirvad do. So he says, आप वध के लिए युद्ध नहीं करना, विजय के लिए युद्ध करो. किसी को वध करने के लिए युद्ध नहीं करना, विजय प्राप्त करने के लिए करो. मीन्स डोंट यूज अंडर रूट्स आर एनीथिंग. तो तुमको मरने के बाद भी सम्मान मिलेगा. देन एज यू सेड, विनिंग इज दैट एंड सक्सेस इज दैट. सक्सेस रिमेन बिकॉज यू वर्क क्लॉथ यू हैव. विनिंग क्या है? कल और कोई जीता, आज तुम जीतेगा, परसों और एक कोई जीतेगा. बट यू वर्क फॉर द सक्सेस, द पाथ व्हाट यू हैव टेकन दैट रिमेन. एंड दैट्स व्हाई दे से दैट. अभी आप देखो थ्योरी, व्हेन आई वाज गिविंग फिटनेस टू वीवीएस लक्ष्मण, आई लर्न दिस. तो 281 मारने के बाद में वो बड़े चीफ मिनिस्टर हो, बड़े बड़े लोग आते थे, उनके साथ सिर्फ 5-10-20 मिनट से ज्यादा स्पेंड नहीं करते थे वीवीएस लक्ष्मण. Whereas a trainer used to be with me for 1 and 1.5 hours. So, main soncha. So, same way, when you win, whether it is Olympic medal or world championship, on victory podium, how many minutes you will be there? Few minutes. But, process, so, which is longest? The process. So, if you enjoy the process, that is more important than you are enjoying the victory. Because victory stand ke par to 5 minutes se zyada nahi rehte. लेकिन उसके लिए इयर्स टुगेदर यू हैव टू ट्रेन. सो यू हैव टू एंजॉय द प्रोसेस, वेदर इज अ कोच और प्लेयर. बिकॉज़ फॉर मी दैट इज आल्सो वन ऑफ द थिंग, बिकॉज़ मुझे बहुत हैप्पी लगता है दैट सेशन गोज वेरी गुड. इफ आई व्हिच आई प्लान द सेशन गोज अकॉर्डिंग टू मी एंड हैपेंस, आई विल बी मोर हैप्पी नॉट विनिंग. सो वन हैज टू एंजॉय द प्रोसेस. सो दैट इज जीतना और सक्सेस में ये है.
Wow, that really good insight, sir. I mean, really great answer to our question. But sir, to conclude, what memory you cherish forever? Aisa ek aapka memory hoga which you would like to share with us that you cherish forever.
Yeah, matlab cherishing moment ek hi nahi hai, hamesha hai aur hote bhi rahega.
Yeah.
My cherishing moment is, as I said, the national anthem and national flag has been high at international stadium in other countries.
Yes.
And when your flag is going up and your national anthem is played, and rest of the country people also have to stand and salute and respect your flag. So immaterial of any field, you are not. But so that made my flag and my national anthem is being respected throughout the world. I hope for that moment always cherish me and keeps on cherish me and bringing the change in the lives of the human beings always make me happy.
I got goosebumps when you said these moments. Really, sir. I mean,
It was a very, very nice talking to you. There were great insights. It was about physical literacy and the coaching philosophies. So much to learn from you, sir. So much to learn at your journey from the village to Dronacharya awardee, the top elite coaches in the country. I mean, it's very inspiring, sir. And I hope the coaches and everybody should, you know, get inspired and get to know you more. It was great, sir. Great talking to you. And thank you so much for joining us and sharing your insights and your views.
First of all, I say thank you too, because so many things nobody asked me so far. I know, first time I'm speaking all this angle, because nobody asked me, and so patiently.
That's the motive, sir. That's the motive. And I want to make a difference. मेरे तरफ से जो भी थोड़ा सा होगा
या नो इट्स अ गुड थिंग यू डिड बिकॉज़ आई टू सो फार इन माय टोटल करियर आई नेवर स्पोक लाइक दिस ओपनली एंड डिफरेंट एंगल्स व्हाटएवर लिटिल एक्सपीरियंस आई गॉट एंड एक्सपोजर आई कुड शेयर डेफिनेटली इफ इट इज इफ वन कोच यंग कोच और वन चाइल्ड और वन पेरेंट गेट द इंस्पिरेशन फ्रॉम दिस और लर्न इट विल बी मींस आवर जॉब इज डन
Yes, sir. I mean, really great, sir. बहुत मजा आया मुझे आज आपको आपके साथ बात करके and बहुत सीखने को मिला सर basically. I mean about this physical
fitness. Hope करते हैं ये जो भी YouTube में देखेगा उनको भी इतना ही मजा आए.
I hope sir. Definitely. Nice sir. Thank you so much.
Yeah, you're welcome. God bless you.
So guys, that was Ramesh sir. He said, as a coach, we are not only making champions, but we are making a good human being out of a player. He has shared his experiences with the Indian hockey team with us. He has shared some of the insights on physical literacy. It was a great learning experience for us. So guys, next week we are having ex-Indian international player and the current national doubles coach, Pradnya Gadre, and she will be sharing her journey with us. So stay tuned, and I'll see you next week. Thank you.